Hello, Kevin Bacon again. And I made mention of shipping a banjo to my son in California. And so there it is behind me. That box is laminated from 5 or 6 different boxes. It is cross-laminated cardboard. I ran the corrugations both directions, glued it all together with white glue. In fact, there are 4 bottles of white glue gluing that together. 4 bottles. One of those bottles is an old bottle of professional woodworker's glue that I had and finished up on there. So it's stuck together pretty good. One entire roll of 3/4-inch masking tape, probably 60 feet of dot matrix type printer paper underneath that, all glued down. Then the brown butcher paper on top is just taped on. It's not glued down. Because I was afraid if I glued it down, then it wouldn't dry fast enough for me to be able to write an address on it. Inside, to pack the banjo itself, I took it out of its case, wrapped it in bubble wrap inside, and stuffed other packing materials around it so that it was secure. First, I had to fix the little door that opens up inside to keep your key. You got to have a key for a banjo. That's what tightens your head. And there may be a pick in there. I'm not sure, but they rattle because they're not gonna hurt anything. Then I put 2 layers of bubble wrap, and then the banjo case on top of that, and then stuffed 2 layers of bubble wrap at each end, and a memory foam packing on both sides of the neck at the top, and then 2 more layers of bubble wrap on top of that, and then I finished the box over top of that. And as I said, it's all glued together. Now, what's going to be interesting is to see how he gets this thing open when he gets it there. We know that he has the other half of this knife, but the question is that going to be enough to get through this stuff? Because I think really what we have back here is a Fort Knox. It's pretty tough. So, I'm going to ask him to take some pictures and send them to me so I can post them when he tears this thing apart, so you can get a look at just how amazingly secure I put this thing together. The banjo is an Aria banjo. It's a very nice banjo. I don't think it's a very expensive banjo. I took the back off, couldn't find any marks or serial numbers on it, but I got it in the mid-80s, I think, when I was down in Louisiana. So I've had it for a long time. It plays very well. So it holds a tune very well. Once you tune it, except for maybe the fifth string, it stays in tune for months and months and months. Okay, so there it is back there. Yes, it's heavy, but it should be safe for the journey. Anyway, I'll let you see it. Ken Bacon. Bye.